Ovarian cancer is often a quiet disease. Few symptoms make it one of the hardest forms of cancer to detect. As a result, tumors are discovered late, making a diagnosis practically a death sentence. But doctors at Scripps Clinic are working on identifying relapse at an earlier point, which could contribute to early detection. Here to discuss the research are Dr. Kelly Bethel of Scripps Clinic and cancer survivor Joan Wiley. Dr. Bethel, tell us how you're using blood samples to understand the spread of this cancer.
We are using a newly developed technology we call the fluid biopsy, which gives us the ability to find cancer cells from an ovarian cancer that are circulating in the bloodstream. So by doing a blood draw, we can find cells from an ovarian cancer and pull them out of the blood cells that make up most of our blood and analyze those cells. So we are doing a bunch of different analyses on those, and we're starting now with women who have already been diagnosed with ovarian cancer to try to pull these cells out and see if they are in early stages of relapse.
So what's the status of the entire research project?
So there are actually multiple parts to the research project, but this part that we're talking about today that's funded by Joan's group has to do with women who have already been diagnosed with ovarian cancer and are either actively treating their disease or who are waiting to find out if they're going to be recurring or not. And we have enrolled about half of the women that we're looking for, so we're looking for about 19 more women right now.
So, Joan, you're a part of this research. Back in 2008, you were diagnosed with stage 4 ovarian cancer. What did it take for you to actually get that diagnosis?
Well, I was actually misdiagnosed by 9 physicians for a total of 6 months. And then I demanded laparoscopic surgery because I knew something was definitely wrong.
And what was your reaction? What was the reaction of the physicians?
Well, during my misdiagnosis, I went from, they usually send you to gastrointestinal doctors, to urologists, to internists, gynecologists, and during that time they kept saying it was either irritable bowel or it was urinary tract infections because it does mimic other diseases. Finally, after the 9th physician, it was a psychologist who told me it was probably in my head. I said, no, I'm going to seek exploratory or laparoscopic surgery, which I did.
So they did it, and then what happened? What's your prognosis at this point?
Well, actually, if I believed in statistics, which 5 years ago they told me I had a 5% chance of actually surviving even a year because I was so bad with my diagnosis. But now here I am 5 years later, and I've been cancer-free with no recurrences, knock on wood, and I'm very, very healthy.
So you've started a group called 9 Girls Ask. What's the group all about? Why'd you start it?
I started it during my chemo because I reached out once I was diagnosed and I had no one to turn to, and I thought it would be so valuable for me to find someone who had walked in my steps before me because it is a very scary disease. And I couldn't find anyone, so I decided to start 9 Girls Ask. For one reason, I have 5 granddaughters and 3 daughters, and myself, we total 9, and we're age 8 to 68. And it does affect women of all ages, even though usually women who are more mature. And I decided I wanted to be there to be able to lend a shoulder to, let someone know what to expect once experiencing ovarian cancer.
And Dr. Bethel, what should women expect when they're experiencing this?
I think that although Joan's experience with the lack of early diagnosis was extreme, I do think it's a disease that presents very vaguely. Unlike many cancers that produce a lump that you can feel, or you get a cough if you have lung cancer, ovarian cancer is very subtle. It produces subtle abdominal discomfort, and so certainly women should aggressively pursue going to their doctor when they're having these vague kinds of symptoms.
And Joan, what were some of your symptoms?
Well, I'd like to actually read the symptoms of ovarian cancer, if it's all right, because I don't want to miss any. So if a woman is experiencing 1, 2, 3 of these for more than 2 weeks, she needs to seek help with her gynecologist. Abdominal pressure, and I had almost every single one of these, abdominal pressure and severe bloating and discomfort, nausea, indigestion or gas, constipation, diarrhea or frequent urination, abnormal bleeding, unusual fatigue, unexplained weight loss or gain, shortness of breath, any of those symptoms, if you combine 2 or 3 of them, you should see your physician.
And we're going to wrap it there. Joan Wiley, Dr. Bethel, thank you so much for coming on the program today.
Thank you so much for having us.